Okay. It's charging. So it's moving. So well, just do that.
It's over the top of what you want to acquire. This is very nice. Yeah. Interesting, this is a lot of iron and sodium. Percent by weight, but 16% roughly sodium by weight, atomic concentration. The sodium all over this area, so I have to see how it compares. Carbon and sodium, okay. It's the iron. Okay. So, the sodium is where the copper is. Definitely the oxygen is where the iron is. Okay, well, that's what we see. The sodium is here, co-located. Zinc and sodium, zinc, sodium. Zinc, sodium, zinc, sodium. Yeah, they do look co-located. Now, is that just a sideband? Is the sodium not there? I think that's not real. I think that's just zinc. I think that's just zinc, yeah. I don't think the sodium is there. Yeah, I don't think the sodium is there. Huh. So, if we kill that, exclude. I think we're seeing iron, oxygen. So it's recalculated that. So yeah, it's iron and oxygen and carbon. Carbon being 21%, so yeah, it's making carbon.
What's going on there?
So, yeah, I don't think there's any sodium there either. I think that's just a slide there. Going to recalculate that. Potassium's definitely there on this one. Okay. And sulfur in these blobs. Okay, what is that? Well, I think I'll have a sample on that. So yeah, more potassium in there. Quite a lot of silicon. We should investigate that little blob. It's a lot of silicon. So the area outside of this zone, this lower chamber zone, appears to have zero carbon and zero anything but copper and zinc and oxygen. Kind of what you would expect-ish. But that's what it says. Carbon and silicon. Iron. And oxygen. Higher oxygen. Whereas this is basically zinc, copper and oxygen outside the zone. Very, very, very clear signal. And basically nothing else there. That is it.